Hey you guys, okay, so today I'm finally doing the home decor updates video that I've been promising probably since like the beginning of the year, definitely since the beginning of all of the whole quarantine. You know, I told you guys, and I think so many of y'all could relate to, that I think my home kind of just took the focus because we were at home so much. And so I got a lot of new things. Some new things came that I ordered. Oh my gosh, these chairs. I think it was like 3.5 months, which I mean, isn't crazy, but that's a, you know, to me, I like to get stuff like, when, you know, like when you want it or whatever. I had to wait a long time for these chairs. And when they finally came, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna finally get the new couch that I want. For years, I had my old white love seat that I really, really loved and actually gave it to someone that, you know, really loves it too. But there was just nowhere to make it work. And, you know, it was a love seat and it had like a roll arm and it was just very basic. It was nice, you know, but I was ready for something new. I wanted something that didn't have like a specific style to it, since these chairs were so, I won't say different, but like rounded, you know. I didn't want anything that had arms. It's a true like sofa, you know, length couch, you know, it's an actual like length of a sofa, but it doesn't take up so much visual like space because it doesn't have arms, and I didn't need arms. I didn't want, you know, round arms that were gonna compete or have like a, this was not a good shirt to wear because as I talk, it's just gonna be like up around my neck. But anyways, I love it. I'll link to it. I've been loving this. It's so soft. You know, I just wanted something that worked. It's just very sleek. I love how it has like a solid, you know, single cushion that isn't split in the middle. The two cushions on the back are, but they're all slip covered, which means, and people ask me that all the time, where do you buy the slip covers for your furniture? And I don't. It's a type of furniture. When you buy furniture, it's called slip covered. It's not what you normally think of, like throwing a sheet over your furniture. It's actually, when you shop for furniture, some couches will say slip covered and some won't. And you won't be able to tell so much by looking at them. It just means that the cushions have a zippable covers that you can wash them, and are really comfy, sectional in our family room is like that as well. You can't ever be too careful. I'm getting ahead of myself. I was really excited to share this because, for one, I have so many different updates. This room, I think especially, just because these three pieces of furniture changed. But I think what really, you know, but I feel like the style is the same. I kept certain pieces, you know, I feel like the look and the feel of the room is the same. It's just so much better, and it's more so even about like what I removed. I removed the two big bookshelves that were here and put them in a room upstairs where we actually needed them, sort of like in an office, like craft room space where we could really like utilize them. In here, they were beautiful, and I thought, well, where am I gonna put my book collection? I got a beautiful new bookcase. It doesn't take up much space. It does the job. You can see all of my covers more. That's a Jonathan Adler candle on top, when I was like going through my Jonathan Adler phase majorly at the last house. Do you remember my pretty horns? Like my Jonathan Adler horns that I had, those white horns that had like the marble that were on my bookcase at the last house. I don't know where those are. And it's one thing that really bothers me, because I'm like, you know what? I remember there was a time when I was kind of over it, and I was like, you know, I had so many Jonathan Adler things, and I found some of my, like I have some mugs, I have some different things, but I was really into it like 7, 8 years ago at our old house, and don't know where those horns are. I wanna hope that they're in the attic or something, but I don't have a lot of like decor stored. So, but I just can't imagine that I would have given them away. I don't know where they are, and that kind of keeps me up at night. I have these beautiful, like really sleek lamps in here, and I thought, you know, I don't need end tables. I don't want that like typical just, you know, two end table look. And I have some nice ones that I used to use in here that I like, that are in, that I use in the basement. But I didn't want that. I don't need that so much in here. Really all I need those for is like a lamp. But in here there's not a lot of space for knickknacks, especially since the bookshelves were moved upstairs. And I like that it gave it like a sleeker look. I feel like it's not so, sometimes I would look in here and I'm like, oh, there's not a lot in the room. The room looked very like open and clean, but it was just, to me, I felt like it looked too much with all those bookshelves. And I showed this a while back on my Instagram. I'm gonna link to everything I'm talking about, but those. And then I added my bar cart, which has been in our actual bar for like the past, I don't know, several years. We have an actual bar in our house in the basement, and we, You know, a bar cart to me is just honestly the same way I feel about when I talk to you guys about leaving out dishes on tables. I've, since the beginning of me ever showing anything about my house, which was probably like, you know, I think I started off with like, you know, Christmas tours like 10 years ago, 11, I don't even know. I don't think I did it my first few years, but like, I don't like a set table. I don't want to set the table until we're about to eat. I don't like it when I see glasses and all that. I'm like, no one wants to be drinking from your dusty glasses. And bar carts, to me, always see them and they've got like an ice bucket on the bottom with ice in it near the floor. Have you ever worked in a restaurant before? Like, big no-no. Who's putting stuff down there? Nobody, okay? Well, apparently a lot of people are. I don't know. I don't like glassware sitting near the floor. I don't want all that. No one's using that, okay? We've got all that stuff in the basement. I don't like to keep liquor sitting out. I think you can make it look cute, but I like that stuff put away. I don't want it in the corner of my living room, but what is genius about a good bar cart? I don't know what this one is. I don't know how old it is. I don't know anything about it. There's no brand on it. I got it from this little store at a farm that we go to years and years ago. I like that it's kind of broken too. Like, it's a little wobbly, but I like that, like, you can't really tell. It doesn't scream bar cart. There's not like a giant handle on one side. It's not like, you know, the handle's kind of discreet, but I like that if we do have people over, like there's times when I've hosted, you know, you have people over for anything, but when you host big things like showers or whatever, My trick is like to keep everyone from just packing into the kitchen, spread out snacks, put like a bowl of nuts in the corner on that with a champagne bucket, you know? I always put a champagne bucket on our built-in bookshelves in the family room to kind of like pull people away sometimes, you know, so that they can go over there and, you know, get drinks or wherever. Sometimes I'll put it on my buffet and my dining room, or just put different things different places. But I think that when you are entertaining, it's nice. You can put stuff on it, and that's a good spot to like kind of have stuff away. But they're genius to use as accent tables. Don't use them as bar carts. Again, I don't like that kind of stuff sitting out, and I feel kind of like, you know, and I'm not saying like, well, it's because we have a bar in the basement, okay? Not everybody has that, or even a lot of, you know, even just use some cabinet space in your kitchen, you know? But the point is people don't always go down there, you know, if we're doing something like that. No one's going down to the basement to use the bar unless if, like, something, you know, I've got something specific set up down there or whatever. But most of the time it's, like, on the main level of the house, and that's a good spot to put stuff if you wanted to. Even if you didn't have that space, I just don't think they're at all practical if you have children, if you have animals. I'm even careful about what I put on my coffee table. Like, I am very anti, like, usually used to, okay, would never decorate really the top of a coffee table. Like, we have like an ottoman in our family room, but I guess that's like comfortable. I don't want little knick-knackies on there when we're like throwing a ball around in there or just like lounging around. It's gonna get knocked over, okay? But in here I kind of like doing that now, especially since I feel like there's not a whole lot going on. Like, I can get away with that more. Used to, I would just put stuff under here. And that's what I really like about a coffee table like this. This exact one isn't available anymore, but I found some really similar ones. This is just the best coffee table. I love it so much. And it's, you know, especially now without those big bookshelves, that bookshelf holds so much, but I can put pretty ones down here that I like. I can, you know, put a few things on top of it. I have a little box and a candle, and then some of these candles with electric LEDs, battery powered LEDs. Because first of all, okay, I never light that candle on here. I just don't. My dog, I like that one. That one is lit. That one's pretty. I'll get into the details on that in a minute, but my dog, his tail, like, he could just be walking through here, not even swinging his tail. I mean, that's dangerous, right? And he'll knock over stuff. These are very heavy. They're very, you know, it's not getting knocked over. But I kind of like those little fake candles. I'm not into fake candles a lot, but I like those. I think those are kind of pretty. But I think these are just, I think those are cool. I think that's good. Or just leave nothing in that. That's what I did over there on the cart. Something else good about that is find one that has three tiers if you can. Like I said, don't know anything about that one. Don't know where it's from. It feels kind of old. I don't know if it is. But I like the three tiers because it's more space to decorate. I considered putting just like a round little pedestal table over there, just a little accent table. But you can't put, I couldn't have put all that stuff on the surface of that table without it looking junky. And I love what I have on there. I have my grandma's tea set that used to sit in on her coffee table at her house. It's got like real gold handles and it's very like opalescent and rainbowy and just so pretty, and I used to always love it when I would go to her house. Just a little like Hermes plate in front of it. I have that Nudesse candle, which that's like the second one I've had like that one. Let me talk about these candles really quickly. I think the Nudesse is my favorite. Like I said, that's my second one that I've had. I talked about these candles a few years ago, but I will say, I'm looking around, that one is my favorite. This one is good. I don't know if you guys know this, but the different scents have a different sort of colored container. This is the one that I keep in the middle of my dining room table. I think it's really pretty in the middle of the table there. And these are so beautiful when they're lit up. But these are nothing new. I told you guys about these years ago. And also a couple years ago, I shared this candle, the Byredo Treehouse. And I said, do not waste your money. Don't be stupid. It smells like a crayon, like a wax crayon. It's almost down to the very bottom because it's just one of those candles. Honestly, you light it and you forget that it's on. Hate to say that, but you know, it's just not that special. But as I got to the bottom of it, or to the halfway point and below, it has a really nice, sweet smell to it, actually. It's not like a hit you in the face crazy scent. Is it like a crayon, kind of? It's like a sweet crayon. That's what it should be, sweet crayon. But I just like the way that it looks. So that one is on this table right here. But those are some of my little accessories in here. And to finish up that table though, on, you know, on the top beside the candle, I have a couple of little paper candle holders that don't have candles in them. I just think they're so beautiful. I'll link to those. I've got a box on top of some books, just, you know, books I like to use as decor. I really collect decorating books. But yeah, okay, that's what's happening there. Like, I am not one particular style. I think if you say, oh, I'm this or I'm that, your home's gonna look like either a movie set. If you're just like all farmhouse stuff, all traditional stuff, all super, you know, modern stuff, or it takes the uniqueness out of your pieces that you think might be super unique if everything is too much of the same. You've got to have some contrast. I like when you come into my house, it's very like pretty traditional molding. It's this room that's like very like paneled and like white on white, like paneling and beautiful traditional molding. And then you look through and you see, you know, some different unexpected stuff, or you see like, you know, a more rounded chair, that something that looks a little bubbly or different. And I think that's fun. A little bit like, you know, mix in some different unexpected things, some clear pieces. You know, it's some textured things. It's not always about like, okay, this is gonna be super creative because I'm gonna paint color all in this room. I think that's so boring. Like, I'd rather have a blank canvas where I can add really exciting things or meaningful things or things that are fun. It's about how things make you feel. I think I'm more like traditional, European, like I don't even know what you would call it. And then a little bit of modern, a little bit of just a mix. Do you know what I mean? Like to throw in something weird every now and then. If you've got like round chairs, I was this close to getting the couch that went with this, or the little love seat. So glad I didn't, because it wouldn't have been as special. You know what I mean? I think you've got to counterbalance it with something, you know, not so rounded. But I got pillows in the same exact material that I just happened to find from somewhere else. I'll link to them. It is the same exact material. I put them on the couch. It ties everything together. These are the best chairs. They swivel. Oh my gosh. Oh, and my curtains. Oh my gosh, you guys. So a while back when we painted this room, right at the beginning of March, I painted this room, and we of course took down the hardware, the hardware of the drapery and stuff. And I needed nicer drapery hardware in our bedroom, because what I was using up there was kind of junky. I would like move the curtains and it would like fall apart. So we moved those upstairs because I really had my heart set on these beautiful lucite and brass ones. And I think it made such a big difference. I'm using the same curtains. I love that hardware so much. And then of course we have the new light in here. So I think it kind of looks, it kind of goes together. I don't know, it's just pretty. And I really, really, really love that light. But yeah, and I don't know, and I don't really want to, okay, I like this rug. A lot of people ask about it, especially like when I do like photos on Instagram. You might notice it's changed a few times because I had one for Olivia's room. I just kind of swapped them around. But this one I really do love. But I bought the same, I love this one so much that I bought it in a larger size for our family room, and that one sheds so much. It's like not even like the same rug. My friend I know she said hers didn't shed, that was this size. I don't know, okay, whatever. My point is, don't know if I could really truly recommend this rug because I don't know if it would shed really bad for you, but I will link to it. I really do think it's a pretty rug and it kind of goes with whatever. I'm trying to think of anything else to share for this room. I would really recommend all this new stuff though. Like these chairs, I love so much. They're so comfortable and really well made, as well as the couch. I'll link to that. They have been doing so many great sales where I got that couch, so crazy. So I got mine for 30% off when I ordered mine and it was in stock. It only took like, I think it was like less than a month for it to come, so that was good. Okay, so quickly, in the dining room, I haven't changed up a lot in here, but it really does feel like I did because I found the perfect solution. Some of you guys may have noticed this last couple months on Instagram, these clear pedestals. I got them from like an art display shop, okay? I'll link to where I got these from. In there, I've always struggled with wanting to put something in that corner, but like it always looks like too much. I want some place to sit some knickknacks or to sit something, or in those cases, those urns that I really, really love. I just think they look beautiful. I love how they look with the curtains. And I've got to just be honest with you guys, I struggle with dining room chairs. I love our table. We have that beautiful marble table in our dining room. And you can kind of see the candle that I was talking about on top of there. But let me just, okay? I have gone back and forth for so many years about what type of chairs to put around that table. And, you know, I think chairs can really kill a table a lot of times. Like, or you've got a good vibe going on in a room, and then, like, if you get nice chairs, that's all you're going to see. Well, then if you find really, not cheap chairs, but if you think, wow, these are two for $99 at Target, they look nice. Well, when you get eight of them, that's all you see in the room, and you're going to notice that they might not be as great as you thought they were. So I think the last year we lived at our old house, I started collecting ghost chairs. I bought one for a desk, and then I was like, ooh, I want to put one more over here. I want to put one more over here. And so over the years, I've collected about 10 of them. I've got them in different spots. When I hosted the last shower that I did here, I put little tables all outside around the pool and under the back porch, and I just busted out my chairs because you can stack those, and I had them literally stacked in the attic, you know, for a while. Just pulled them out, put, you know, wiped them off, and they were great for the party. But they're really pretty around a dining room table, and sometimes over the years when I've tried them there, it kind of starts messing my mind because I'm like, do I want plastic chairs like around my dining room table? But something about them, they're just so pretty. They don't cause a lot of like visual, you know, I don't know, not a lot of visual weight, but I think that there's just something so charming about them. Do you guys remember on Gossip Girl, what's her, the girl's name? Blair's mother, you know, they had that crazy, like, beautiful apartment, whatever. Her mom had those ghost chairs in their dining room, but she had, like, cushions in them. And so, yeah, you can put cushions in them. I've seen people put, like, little, like, fur throws in them. But that room is just so beautiful. I don't keep any blinds on that window. It's such a pretty view out that window with the trees, and you can see the pool out there and pretty, you know, hydrangeas. And I just don't want to be looking through a whole bunch of chairs. I think, honestly, it's kind of pretty to put ghost chairs in front of a window. When we first moved in here for years, I had one in front of each one of those windows for like extra seating, but it didn't, like, you know, get in the way of the view. So I have really been liking that. I've really been loving those chairs in there. So that's really what's been going on in there. So yeah, don't underestimate a few clear pieces. I've always loved doing that. I think that's such a special little table. And then over here in this room, this is the one, you know, area that I didn't show yet, but I love this table. I've had it for years. It used to be in the foyer. I love to load up picture frames kind of in a group, and then, you know, some books with a candle on top with the crayon candle. And then this lamp, you guys, I got, I think the first year we lived at the old house, probably like a 10-year-old lamp. Do you guys remember when Target had these? It's like a solid, really heavy lamp, and I think I remember it was like $60 at the time, and I always wish that I bought two. That is the most beautiful lamp. It's so sparkly and pretty, and again, next to that bookshelf, or if you've got a table with a lot on it, it's not like a chunky lamp, you know? The clear, like the glass doesn't take up a lot of visual space, so it doesn't look too cluttered, and it gives a little like bit of shine and sparkle. So moving into the family room, I have some different things that I have a few things that I wanna show you guys in there. Let's just move on in there, okay? Let's go. And so in the foyer, you know, you can see a little bit more of, like, you know, the molding in the walls and stuff. But these lights, you guys, I don't think I've ever talked about them. We've had them up for a couple years now, And I just want to like rave about these for a second. They're not so style specific. I think you could use them pretty much anywhere. I also grabbed this mirror a couple months ago. They were doing, I think the mirror was like 40% off or something crazy. I really hope that they still have it. It's a beautiful teak wood mirror. So in our family room, I feel like not a whole lot has changed, but my very favorite thing that I've gotten recently is this fireplace screen. And I've had a few over the years, and I always just feel like, you know, especially in a room like this where it's like, this is the focal point, you've got the TV, you know, the two built-ins, which I removed the bookshelves from those and added the mirrors. I want to say like over a year ago. I think it's plenty of space to have the one shelf, you know, above the cabinets. It was just too much and they were unnecessary. So I really like how it looks. But anyways, I found that like, I just never could really settle on one that I really loved. And when we got our logs a couple years ago, I really was picky about the ones that I got. I wanted these that were like white birch logs. I just thought they were different and pretty, but then you could never see them because we had that, you know, that screen on there. So I found this, and of course I'm gonna link to everything, like, you know, I told you guys. It even came in a version that had brass, you know, pieces. I really like the silver on this. I think it's really pretty, and it's just, again, like adding something that's glass, it just adds a little bit of sparkle, even though it's not like sparkle. You know what I mean? I don't know. I love glass. I love clear, whatever. It's just pretty. And then we have like the clear handles on the book, you know, on the cabinets and stuff that I think it kind of like goes, you know, too matchy, but I just think it kind of works. Another thing that I really love in here, I don't know if you can see it, but I'll kind of show you closer up. You can kind of get an idea of like how I've styled these, you know, the tops of these shelves, or the tops of whatever you want to call them, the cabinets. This little lamp is so, so cute. It's honestly like not even so much for light, because the bookshelves have the recessed lighting in the top. It's just a little sweet accent light that honestly looks like a piece of art on its own. It's got this really heavy, beautiful marble round base, and you know, it's just kind of sculptural and cute and pretty. And a lot of people always ask, you know, where are your cords? How do you hide it? Which of course not, like, we've got our Nintendo Switch hooked up, so it's like there was no way to avoid those cords. But if you can see, I'll kind of show you guys. The cord kind of runs behind the mirror, whatever. And then there's a little hole in the top of the cabinet that goes down into the cabinet itself, where there's a lot of, like, you know, space to plug stuff in. There's a hole in the wall up there that the cords from the TV go in, and you can see where those come in as well. And then all the TV components are in the cabinets. And you know, remotes now, you don't even have to, like, so it's fine that it's closed in. Remotes, you don't, you could be like in the, I could be in the dining room and press something, the TV would turn on, because it's just like, I don't know what the word for that is, but you don't have to like point it anymore. So it's okay for the pieces to be, or what am I trying to say, the components to be like enclosed. So when people ask, that's where they are. And these lamps, and another question, the lamps are plugged in under the couch. These lamps, speaking of, okay. But I love these so much. They're so beautiful and unique. Again, they have that clear element to them. So like looking through from our family room into this room, or from our family room into the kitchen to the family room, this is like what people say, an open concept. I do like a kitchen open to a family room. That makes sense. But I don't want every room on my main level open to one another. You know what I mean? I think there's a stopping point. But I love how these rooms kind of connect. But sometimes when I've had certain lamps there, I feel like when I'm in the kitchen, I'm like, you know, looking around the lamps. And I like those because they're so beautiful, and they're such like a statement, and they're so pretty when they're lit up at night. They're just so beautiful. But they don't take up a lot of like visual space. You know what I mean? Like, you can see through them. I don't know, okay. But something that I'm so excited about that is actually coming, when is this going up? This will go up Friday. It's actually coming on Saturday, so it's coming tomorrow. I'm getting a new piece to go, like a console to, or what's it, a credenza to go right there instead of that open wood piece. I love that. I'm actually gonna put that in the basement. I'd actually put that down there and swapped some things around a while back, and it ended up coming back up because, you know, I'm like always swapping things around. But I found that, especially like even just for things in the kitchen, like extra placemats, or, you know, now like heading out that back door to go to the pool, you could put pool towels in there or whatever. I like how ours is on the main level up here, because it's weird, like our basement kind of goes off to the side, so you don't really see that under part down there. But we leave out right there, and I never have like a good spot to keep our towels. I've thought about keeping them somewhere outside, but, you know, I just want to keep them inside where they can stay like dry and clean. And they're just on a shelf in the laundry room, which I really want for other stuff, and which would be nice to store other things on, but I think it's gonna be really nice having some extra space. It is so beautiful. Cannot wait to get it, but I'll update y'all when I get that. I always think of, like, when I hear that word, credenza, is that like the same thing on like the three-handled family credenza on Cat in the Hat? Is that what he was talking about? I always thought that was so funny when I was a kid. A three-handled family credenza. Is that what it is? Credenza. Is it the same thing? I don't know. It was called a credenza, so I'm calling it a credenza. I can't wait to show that. And I'll show that when I do my kitchen video soon, because there's a few changes now that I'm like going through all this that we're making in the kitchen. Let's pull this over because it was just chilling. But this table, you guys, this is such a nice end table that I never really had one to put at the edge of my, you know, at the edge of the, at the edge of the sectional right there. I never had like a big end table because I'm like, you know, I don't really need anything that sticks out too much or that's too decorative or that I don't want knickknacks. I mean, I could put something cute on this. This is, it's so heavy. It's a black marble. You could even slide it under something, but it's very low, okay? So be aware of that. But it's just the perfect end table. I love, they have it in white marble. They have all different color metal that you can pick. But I just wanted the black on black. I just thought it was kind of a cool contrast in here. And something about the black marble, I just think is so like chic and pretty. Check the link below, or check the box below, because I'm gonna try to link to everything that I showed. You know what I mean? Even if I didn't mention it, I'm gonna link to my candle here and the thing and I'll link to the mirrors, everything. So, and then I do, like I said, I have so many other things that I wanna share with you guys. A few things that aren't done yet. That's why I said, you know, it's always our doing a home tour, because for me, everything's always changing. So I just never feel like I'm at a point where it's ready, which I guess it never will be. So whatever, I guess I'll just share. Anyways, but I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. I had the best time chatting with y'all today. Those videos will come up soon though, with the kitchen, and there's some things that I wanna show you. And then our bedroom, you know, I'll do another video where I'm showing some other updates. But thanks you guys so much for watching. I love y'all so much. Have a wonderful weekend, and I'll talk to you very soon. Bye, you guys.